Hi, I'm Gina, your GIA gemologist. Today I'm going to talk to you about fake turquoise jewelry. Whether your turquoise is fake or what is the alternative and what is it made of. So let's get started. Right here, I want to show you the difference between a couple of pieces we're going to be talking about. We're going to be talking about real turquoise, and then we're going to be talking about Chrysocolla and Howlite, which is used to fool you. And the difference between the two or three. So let's get started first with turquoise. Turquoise, the color is always a greenish blue to a pale blue in color. Another name that we use for turquoise would be that you might recognize as Persian turquoise, which is more like the robin egg color. So it tends to be more this beautiful color. Now that can also be in your jewelry where there's no veining and it's perfectly flawless. But I want you to look at turquoise a little closer. Real turquoise should have veining in it. It should have some mottling in it, mottling. That would be what a turquoise indication would be. Now, the difference between the slight veining and this deep veining, this deep marbling, we're going to talk about marbling, would be something called howlite. Now, howlite is not real. Howlite actually comes very light, it's very porous, and it's very easy for it to be dyed. Whereas turquoise is a harder stone, and it's more dense, so it's not as easily to be dyed and used in your fake jewelry as howlite. So howlite can come in many, many different colors. So I wanted to just tell you about those two differences at the moment. Now we're going to go a little deeper, and it's called Chrysocolla. Chrysocolla is more like your ocean colors. It's like your forest green. So this is, you can see a slight green coloring here, and you can see this beautiful, almost a Persian color. This would be like your robin egg, but that would be your Chrysocolla. Chrysocolla is not, it is a copper-based mineral, so it would not be your turquoise-based, which is copper and aluminum mineral-based. So Chrysocolla is very soft. It starts at like a 2 on the Mohs scale, where turquoise is like a 5.6, so it's a lot harder. So we know that the difference between the two is, or the three, is visually you're going to look at this heavy marbling in your howlite. You're going to look at the Chrysocolla, which is your ocean or your green, forest green colors, and then you're going to look at your turquoise, which is a harder, it's got lighter veining, it's more mottled, it's got maybe some dark blotches, okay? Let's test them. So when we test these stones, because as I mentioned, the hardness differs on all of these, we're going to use a little sharp implement. We're going to dig it into the stone, just in an area where it's not going to be seen. Could be close to the close to an edge or near the threading of a bead. Go in and scratch it. Do the scratch test. The scratch test is going to show you that the softer the stone, the less likely that it's real. Turquoise is harder, so it's going to scratch less. It's gonna, or not at all, with your scratching implement. So that would be one, that's the way that you would look at it or and test it, by scratching it. So now we've done the different visual that you're looking at, the visual characteristics, and then we're actually doing the testing characteristics. And with that said, I hope those tips really helped you today. Recently, a Facebook group page follower sent me her Navajo belt, which we looked at, and we talked about the different ways of testing it. So one last thing I want to tell you, one last tip. If it's too good to be true, test further and make sure that you aren't fooled by something that may not be real. So I hope that helped. Please subscribe. I have lots more tips that I want to talk to you about. And I look forward to helping you with your estate and with your jewelry values. Take care.